I'm just going to read to you a little bit from my introduction in the pamphlet in Lake's Mystic Map of London. Cities have always offered walkers and thinkers a geographical landscape that is both historically familiar and strangely futuristic, that can stimulate and meditate our minds and allow us to dream, to plan, to reinvent. In the 19th century, the poet Charles Baudelaire came up with the concept of the flâneur, whose leisurely walks around Paris reflected the impact modern cities were having on the human psyche. But much earlier, in 18th century London, we find the visionary poet and artist William Blake wandering through London from boyhood, actually, because it's his native hometown, intuitively understanding and responding to the way conflicting energies inherent in city life can affect us. And this is the key thing, I think, conflicting energies. And I think this is something really important at the moment in everywhere, but I'm in London, I'm in this city. We've been going through the coronavirus, a pandemic. These anxieties which are within us all when we sense danger and threat, similar to the way Blake and maybe others in the 18th century felt that way about urbanisation and industrialisation of the city, felt like the world that they knew would be completely destroyed and something so alien would come in its place that they did not feel like they were at home anymore. I feel like Blake is a good voice to listen to right now for this very reason. Because for him, in a way, the city is like a huge human being. You know, the streets, the roads, they're like the veins, they all lead to the heart, the centre. For him, the centre is where he spent his boyhood, Soho, Broad Street, Golden Square, and where he spent his working life, South Molton Street, Lambeth, for instance. And all these areas represent a different part of, in a way, what it is to be human, but sort of deeper solidified, so in a city form. And this is what inspired me for this pamphlet, this idea that a city can be alive and breathing, and it can collectively somehow expressed to us the way in Blake's day there was no Twitter, there was no social media, but the way social media can collectively communicate to us how people are dealing. I think Blake kind of sensed this because he had this incredible spiritual connection with what he felt was in the air, what was going on, what was happening. And he expressed this with a sense of urgency in his poetry. And for me, he's been an incredible inspiration as a wanderer of city streets myself. I always have been. I've always loved to experience the city in that free way. If you like, he's the daddy of that. He's the daddy of the imagination seeker and those who want to be able to create their own golden city, their own sacred places, their own ownership. Not in a physical capitalist way, but in an emotional and psychic way, their own ownership of place. And why this is so important to us, and why it is particularly important to us in eras like right now, where we are facing so many destabilizing forces all around us. Anyway, I hope that you will join me on the 12th of August, which is the anniversary of William Blake's death, as I'm going to have an online virtual art exhibition, which will be the